You hear the screeching of an owl. You hear the wind begin to howl. You know there's zombies on the prowl. And it's terror time again. They've got you running through the night. It's terror time again. And you just might die of fright. It's a terrifying time.
I started when my kids were little, and my birthday's Halloween, so my mom always decorated for me. And so I continued to decorate for my kids, and it's just grown from there. It was an older street when I moved on it, and a lot of young couples moved in with kids, and it just grew from there. No, the expectations is for herself, trying to get decorations up. Once they're up, we enjoy it. It's kind of fun to visit with all the different people that come from all over the place to spend their time here.
It can be a little stressful living on the street because people start driving around pretty early and walking down the street in the middle of October. And as you can see with our house, we have a big part of our display are the pumpkins, and we can't carve them too soon or else they rot, so we're always kind of like trying to get it done. You know, it's kind of a time crunch at the end of the month there. Last year we carved them earlier and it was a warm October, so they're all rotting and smelling, and we had to go get all new ones and carve them again, which is not fun to carve 50 pumpkins. So yeah, but all in all, we really like living here and we like doing it for the kids and for the families to have something fun and free to do. Come and see.
The scariest is probably with the electric chair up at the top of the street, but the neighbor across the street has a special thing this year that he hasn't brought out, and he's going to bring out towards the end. I'm not going to tell what it is, but that one's scary. Even though I knew what was going to happen, it still scared me.
Matt Ponke, because, you know, Matt has the electrocution guy, you know, and I remember my daughter when she was young, she was always scared of that guy. She called him the bumpy guy. But, you know, Tim now has got the lawnmower man, you know, where the lawnmower's running over the guy and his feet's going up and down. And now he's got, I think, a gas chamber guy, you know, he's going to put out. And you won't see it until, you know, the very end. But I think his is kind of the scariest. We try to be, like, family friendly, you know, so, you know, moms won't be having a bad time with their kids having pictures of that.
I think the best house on the street is probably the Ponkies at the end there that have Sparky and the ghosts in the window and the talking and all of that. They have some pretty cool stuff going on, like production style, where there's film and sound and everything.
Matt Ponke, he's got the coolest one, top of the hill.
But we kind of started it along with Vicky. Vicky was the instigator because it's her birthday on Halloween. But, you know, originally we just put up some fake trees and a vulture, and we had a little sign, you know, Witch's Forest. I turned back if I were you. So it was kind of the Wizard of Oz thing, you know. But then we moved on to bigger and better things, so.
And when we moved here, we did not know about Tillson Street. Our realtor told us, oh, this is Halloween Street. And we thought, oh, we like Halloween. But I didn't really know exactly what that entailed or how involved it really is until my first year, which we got the keys about 10 days before Halloween. So we were pretty blown away by how everything really takes off and how busy it is. Everybody,
Well, originally we started with a conga line, you know, where we had, you know, five of them in a row, and then they were all dancing around, and then we had some tables set up and some chairs so you could sit next to them and have your picture taken. And then it morphed into, you know, a ballroom, you know, where they all had to have masks. That's why we have the ornate mask on the people here. And then after that, it morphed into the mosh pit. And I think we're going to be going steampunk next year, you know, so I don't know. I've got to check with the wife and the daughter.
I don't know. This is, my grandparents did this, so that's what we do. And we bought the house from them, so.
You hear the screeching of an owl, you hear the wind begin to howl. You know there's zombies on the prowl. And it's terror time again. They've got you running through the night. It's terror time again. And you just might die of fright. It's a terrifying time. Screaming's gonna start. Here comes the really scary part. Cause it's terror time again. Got you running through the night. It's terror time again. Oh, you just.
Hi, I'm Taylor. We're here on Tillson Street, located next to Dairy Queen off of Main Street in Romeo. You can pick up t-shirts near the middle of the street. Have a happy Halloween. Monsters grunt and groan, rotting
faces full of slime. Don't you know it's terror time? And it's terror time again. They've got you running through the night. Yes, it's terror time again. Oh, you just.
Alrighty, don't exactly know what's going on, so let's chat. The proceeds for the Tillson Street t-shirts go towards school scholarships, and remember, the houses are only lit up till 11 p.m. because people need to sleep. So let's try and get back to see what's going on at Tillson.
Got you running.